First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of my sea. Oh, ooh, the master of my sea. Oh, ooh. I was broken from a young age, taking my soak into the masses, writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me, feeling me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the...
Hi guys, I'm back. On our previous vlog, we talked about Gamaba Awardees in literature and performance. But now, we're gonna talk about Gamaba Awardees in arts and crafts, which is Eduardo Mutok, Lang Dulay, Salinta Monon, Hadja Amina Api, Magdalena Gamayo, The Heart of Sawabi, Cupilo Garcia. So, here again, my amazing friends are the details will definitely help you understand more about Gamaba art. Roll B. Hello guys, we are finally back here in Jeprox and we are going to discuss about Eduardo Mutok. So who is Eduardo Mutok anyway? Eduardo Mutok is an artist who has dedicated his life to creating religious and secular art in silver, bronze, and wood. His intricately detailed retablos, mirrors, altars, and carrozas are in churches and private collections. His studio occupies a corner of his yard and shares space with a tailoring shop. During the recent rains, the river beside his lot overflowed and water flooded in his studio. In a palit Pampanga, drenching his woodblock, he was 29 when he decided to supplement his income from farming for the relatively more secure job of wood carving. His daily wage of 3 pesos didn't go far to support his wife and the first 3 of 9 children. One of them has already died. Choices were limited for a man who only finished elementary school. When he's working on metal work, he begins with a detailed drawing. He then transfers the design on a block of wood by chiseling out the details. He then covers the wood with a metal sheet, then coaxes out the design through careful hammering with a mallet and an old rubber slipper. Afterwards, he dips the solid metal sheet in molten silver. He then proceeds to do more hammering and polishing to bring out the details of the piece. Mutok's works are more than merely decorative. They add character and splendor to their setting. His spectacular shiny retablos that decorate an abbot or chapel provide focus for contemplation and devotion, while the faithful commune with the divine in regular church celebrations. According to him, craftsmanship begins with respect for one's tools and the medium. Wow, he's really dedicated and passionate on what he is doing. Now let's move on to the next topic, which is Teofilo Garcia. Roll BTR.
Teofilo Garcia. He was awarded in the year 2012. He was from San Quintin of Abra. He is an Ilocano. The term Ilocano was derived from the words I means from and Luo, and Luo means Bay, which when combined means people of the Bay. He is a master of artisan, farmer, and innovator. He was known for making the all-weather headgear, a well-made tabungaw, which can last up to 3 to 4 generations if taken care of properly. He made his works with passion and dedication and devalued his works by making necessary steps to preserve his artworks. He was cited for his efforts from keeping the traditional tabungaw, making alive and vibrant. Tabungaw is a distinctive and functional headpiece that he made to protect him from the harsh rays of the sun and the rain. His contribution to contemporary arts is the integration of his crafts in Abra's Harvest Festival. Roll VTR.
All around me are familiar faces, worn out places, worn out faces, bright and early for their daily races, going nowhere. Go.
The next Gumabaw Worthy in our craft is Salintamonon. Salintamonon is a textile weaver from the tribe of Tagabawa Bagobo. Bagobo comes from Bago, meaning new or recent. Obo means good. Salintamonon is from Bansalan, Davao del Sur. She was awarded at the year 1998 and she died at 2009. She started learning weaving from her mother at the age of 12. Her family is among the remaining Bagobo weavers in the community.
And I am here with you to share some information about Haja Amina Api as Sama. The Sama or Samal covers a diverse grouping of Sama Bajau speaking people. Fishing, boat building, and iron working are primarily male occupations, while weaving mats and marketing pottery are jobs for women. Haja Amina Api of Umas Matatatan Subas Tawi Tawi.
So, what is your name?
My name.
Yes, your name.
My name is Ovuvwe Vwavwe Enyetwenwe Vwe Ubemubim Osas.
Haja Amina Papi of Umas Matatatan Tubas Tawi Tawi.
Pardon? Come again.
Haja Amina Papi of Umas Matatatan Tubas Tawi Tawi.
Jesus! How would they spell it for you?
Is recognized as the master mat weaver among the Sama indigenous community of Umas. She is awarded last 2004. Her colorful mats with their complex geometric patterns exhibit her precise sense of design, proportion, and symmetry, and sensitivity to color. The whole process is exclusive to women. It is a long and tedious process and requires long patience and stamina. The process starts with the harvesting of wild pandan leaves from the forest. The Sama weavers prefer the thorny leaf variety because it produces stronger and sturdier matting strips. Although the thorns are huge and unrelenting, Haja does not hesitate from gathering the leaves. And because commercial dyes are often not bold or striking enough for her taste, she has taken to experimenting with color and developing her own tints to obtain the desired hues. Her favorite colors are red, purple, and yellow, but her mats sometimes suit her up to 8 colors at a time. Her complicated designs gain power from the interplay of various shapes. According to her, what is more difficult than the mixing of the colors is the visualization and execution of the design. It is high-precision work requiring a mastery of the medium and an instinctive sense of symmetry and proportion. Haja Amina is respected throughout her community for her unique design. She is eager to teach and looks forward to sharing the art with other weavers. Haja Amina Papi is awesome, right? That's all. Thanks for listening. I hope you learned something from my short discussion.
Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars, and let me see what the spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words,
so we're gonna talk about Magdalena Gamayo. She is a textile weaver. She is also a Ilocano. She lives in Pinili, Ilocos Norte. She was awarded as Gumabaw Worthy in 2012. Textile weaver of Abel is their traditional blanket. Has taught herself the traditional patterns of binakol, inuritan geometric shapes, kusikos, spiral forms, and sinasabong flowers. She has learned the art of weaving from her aunt and started harnessing her innate skills at the age of 16. Roll with the arm.
Oi! Tigil! Oi, huwag kayo tumalon!
Lang Dulay was awarded in the year 1998. She is a textile weaver from Lake Cebu, South Cotabato. She harnessed her skills at the age of 12 and she's part of the Tivoli tribe. She is skilled in doing the tinalak weaving. Now, let us know more about Lang Dulay from Erica. Dulay knows the 100 designs, including the Bulay Lawi, the Paniki, and the Kabali. Each one special for the story itself. She started weaving tinala at the age of 12. Then Dulay opened Manilikanan Bayan Center to focus on the preservation of the art of Tivoli textile weavings. Using the black and red dyes, she spins her stories with grace. Her textiles reflect the wisdom and the visions of her people. The Tinalak Festival is celebrated July every year. South Cotabato is also known as the land of free weavers. Roll VTR.
Vigorous Adventures.
Next we have Tarhata Sawabi. Is a weaver of the Pisayabit, the traditional cloth tapestry worn as a head covering by the Tausog of Hulo from Barangay in the island of Hulo, Sulu Province. The community of weaver recognizes her expertise in craft, her bold contrasting colors, evenness of her weave, and her traditional designs. Devoted full-time to her craft, she taught interested young generation to pass on the tradition. A Gamaba 2005 awardee she is. Thank you. Roll BTR.
Hi guys, I'm Mac to give you the reflection of our group. So after learning about the lives of these Gamaba awardees in crafts, we learned that with the aid of patience, perseverance, hard work, passion, and love for what you do, you will be able to become successful just like these awardees. Their works were merely decorative and is sought after by many people because of its quality. Craftsmanship begins with respect for the tools and the medium. To improve one's skills and dedicate oneself, learn the technique, and to practice, because only perfecting one's craft can there be a real reward. Once, Leofilo Garcia wanted to give up because it was hard work, but he did not do it for the fear that art might end with him. Despite modern times, these people remain true to their traditions and culture, and they have also preserved their artistic heritage for the present and future generations to come. Thank you for listening. I hope that you understand the information that you have conveyed. Thank you and God bless.
Pinapraktis
ko na. Pangalawa. Ano yun?
Isang kaba.
Pwede? Gusto na ako. Kahit
Basta mabidyoan ako.
Paano?
Ha?
Paano bidyoan?
Cautious
na ikaw!
And Sabong Flowers. She has learned the art from his, from her and...
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of my sea. Oh, ooh, the master of my sea. Oh, I was broken from a young age, taking my soak into the masses, writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me, feeling me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the...